So we are welcome to today's class of English Choice for Basic 7. Basic 7, not Basic 8. This time around, it's for Basic 7. And today's date is 14th July 2020. So don't forget, it is the English Studies class. English Studies class. So our topic for today is conjunctions. So don't forget, last week we discussed preposition under parts of speech. Like I told you that we have 8 parts of speech in English language. These are categories of words or classes of words that we use in English language. So we refer to it as parts of speech in English language. In any statement or sentence you want to construct, you must make use of those parts of speech for you to be able to construct a meaningful sentence. So it is very important to know all these parts of speech. So last week we discussed preposition as the 6th part of speech that we have in English. If you remember very well, I told you there is a little relationship between preposition and conjunction. Although preposition will only state the relationship between pronoun and other words in English language, why this conjunction? It's just like a linking word that links 2 sentences together, or 2 phrases together, or 2 clauses together. So by the time I give you the definition of conjunction, you will see the difference between conjunction and preposition. So inshallah, this morning we are going to discuss preposition in details. First, the definition of it. So we'll later move to some examples under the definition. Then we'll now proceed to the types of conjunction that we have in English language. So may Allah make it easy for us. Now, let me first give us the definition of conjunction. I told you that there is a little relationship between preposition and conjunction. So let's start by the definition of conjunction. Now, a conjunction can be described as a joining word. A conjunction, don't mind my marker. A conjunction can be described as a joining words. So what this is telling us is that why preposition is just telling us about a relationship between a noun, a pronoun, and other parts of speech, conjunction is just to describe, it's just a joining word that joins sentences, that join phrases, or even clauses together. So it's a joining word. It can be described as a joining word. But let's move on. Its major function, let's talk about its major function in English language. So its major function is to join or link together 2 or 3 words. Its major function is to join two or more words, comma, phrases, and sentences together. Once you know the definition of conjunction, you have to know its functions too. Its major function is to join two or more words, either from starting from three, two or more words together, or even two or more phrases together. And lastly, is to join two or more sentences together. So whenever you come across a long sentence, don't forget that there must be a conjunction in such sentence, because is to join anything that is more than one sentence, you will find a conjunction there. It will be something that will be joined two or more words, two or more phrases, and even two or more sentences together whenever you are to construct a sentence. Yes, this is the definition of conjunction. You've seen the difference between the two now, between the preposition that is just telling us, stating the relationship between noun, pronoun, and other parts of speech. That one preposition is only telling us, it's only stating the relationship between a noun, a pronoun, and other parts of speech. While conjunction is a joining word that is linking two words, phrases, or even sentences together. So that is just the difference between the two. Now let's move on to the types of conjunction that we have in English language. So there are two main types of conjunction, types of conjunction. Types of conjunction. Now, there are two major types of conjunction in English. There are two major types of conjunction in English. The first one is coordinating conjunction. The first one is coordinating conjunction. And the other one is subordinating conjunction. So these are the major two types of conjunction that we have in English language. The first one is coordinating conjunction, while the second one is subordinating conjunction. So we are going to explain it one after the other with examples. But don't forget, these are just major types of conjunction that we have. That means that we also have another type which is not major, and that one is correlative conjunction. Is not major, but it's also type of conjunction that we have in English language. Now, I'm going to explain the three, both the major type and the third one that we have, which is not part of the major type that we have in English language. I'm going to explain it with example. I will first give you the example, then we'll now analyze it and categorize it to where it belongs. The first one I'm going to give you is example of a coordinating conjunction. Example. coordinating, conjunction. So under this coordinating conjunction, that is where we have like some, the light of or like or have, and we have but under coordinating conjunction. These are examples of under coordinating conjunction. We have not yet. We have nor and others like that. So these are examples of coordinating conjunction, which is the first major type of conjunction that we have in English language. Another one, like I told you, under major types of conjunction that we have, which is subordinating conjunction. So under it we have subordinating conjunction. So under it we have the likes of subordinating conjunction. Under it we have the likes of because, because we have although. Under it we have because, we have although, we also have as, we have since, we have whenever. Whenever. We also have since. And so on. So these are examples of subordinating conjunction. Like I told you that this third type of conjunction that we have, although it wasn't categorized as one of the major types of conjunction that we have in English language, but still it's also part of conjunction that we have in English. So it's not major, it's not one of the major conjunction, but it's also one of the types of conjunction that we have in English language. And it is correlative conjunction. Correlative conjunction. Correlative conjunction. Under it, we have, it is just combination. The main reason why we call it correlative conjunction is that it's comprised of two words. You can't just use one and neglect the other one and ignore the other one. You have to use the two together in a sentence. We have the likes of both and. Both and. The two must come together in a sentence. We also have not only but also. Not only, but also, the two must be in a sentence. You can't just use one and neglect the other one or ignore the other one. We have neither nor, and we also have either or. Either or. Neither nor. So when I start giving you examples of all these types of conjunction that we have, we are going to see the usage of all these types that we have under correlative conjunction. Now, let's move on. It continues to say that coordinating conjunction and correlating conjunction are used to link sentence parts. Coordinating conjunction and correlative conjunction. That is this third type of conjunction, and this first one, which is coordinating and correlating, are used to join sentence parts together. So how do we do that? That will be explained when I start giving you example all that is. And the third one, which is the second type of conjunction that we have, which is coordinating conjunction, are used to join main clauses to other clauses together. We have main clause and we also have subordinate clause. So we are going to use this type of conjunction to join the two together. So let me start with this example. The man spoke well and everybody was satisfied. Example. The man spoke well and everybody was satisfied. So if you look at this sentence, if you look at this example, we are going to discover that we have conjunction here, which is and the type of conjunction of coordinating conjunction, which is the first one. The man spoke well and everybody was satisfied. You just say this statement like this, or this one. The man spoke well. You can just keep quiet. That means you started with something and you are continuing to say something. They know that you are still talking to someone. The man spoke well. You are still making sense by saying that it is an independent clause, or you call it main clause. That means it can stand on its own main clause or independent clause. A clause that doesn't depend with the other. The man spoke well. But you can't just join these two clauses together without making use of conjunction. That's just the essence and the function of conjunction here. You can't just say the man spoke well, everybody was satisfied. It won't make sense. But if you introduce conjunction, which is coordinating conjunction, to it, it's going to give you a chance to join the two clauses. Everybody was satisfied. It's another statement, another clause, which is main, because it has its meaning. Everybody was satisfied. Everybody was satisfied. So we use this type of conjunction, which is coordinating conjunction, to join these two clauses, main clauses, together. Now, another example is this. I should travel to Lagos if I have enough money. I shall travel to Lagos if I have enough money. That means I won't be able to travel to Lagos if I don't have enough money with me. So our conjunction here is if, which falls under coordinating conjunction. But if you look at the first statement, I shall travel to Lagos. I shall travel to Lagos. It is still under main clause. because it has meaning. I shall travel to Lagos. So we don't know when you are traveling to Lagos, maybe tomorrow or next week, but you've already made a statement. You are traveling to Lagos. If that we have here, it is subordinating conjunction. This time around, it is not coordinating conjunction, because it is linking and joining main clause and subordinate clause, which is not main, which is dependent. This one is subordinate, not main this time around. Subordinate clause, or you call it dependent. Dependent clause. It cannot stand on its own. I have enough money. If you have enough money, if you have enough money, what are you going to do? So, but this is telling us that if you have enough money, you are going to travel to Lagos. So, if here, subordinating conjunction, it is subordinating conjunction because it is joining both main clause and that of subordinate clause together. I shall travel to Lagos. You can just keep quiet like that. That means you are still making sense. If I have enough money, you can't just keep quiet like that. If I have enough money, what are you going to do if you have enough money? You need to explain for that, for us to get what you are trying to say. You can't just have enough money and keep quiet like that. What are you going to use your money for? So you have to use it for something. You need to tell us what you want to use your money for. So that is the second example. We have another example here, which is Abibat spoke quickly but courteously. Another one. Abibat spoke quickly but courteously. This is another statement. Abibat spoke quickly. It's the main clause. You are making sense. You are still giving us, you are telling us something, and we understand what you are trying to say. Courteously, but courteously. But here is an example under which of the conjunction? Is it coordinating or subordinating conjunction? We have it under coordinating conjunction. Abibat spoke well, but courteously. That means she can speak quickly, but we are going to understand what she is saying. But we'll be cautious with what she's saying. You won't just be talking and be saying something that does not make sense. Another one is, my dad cooks the food and my mother serves it. My dad cooks food and my mother serves it. So this is another one. This is another example. My dad cooks food and my mother serves it. Maybe when your dad is less busy, you can just try and surprise the whole family. If you want to cook the food, that's the, just to surprise the whole family when he's less busy. My dad cooks food and my mother serves it. That means they are supporting one another. It is still under coordinating conjunction because of this, and that is joining the two statements, the two clauses together. So lastly, let me give you this last example. Although the couple have been married for 10 years, although longer. Although the couples have been married for 5 years, they have not had a child. So if you look at this sentence, our conjunction here is that we put it at the middle of the sentence or the middle of two sentences. We have it at the beginning. It can come at the beginning of the sentence. Although the couple have been married for 10 years, they have not had child. So it's telling us that it's not just that you can have conjunction at the middle of every sentences or every sentence or at the middle of two sentences or clauses. You can also have it at the beginning of the sentence. Now, let me give you example under this correlative conjunction where you can make use of two words together in a sentence. Something like this, you can just say both Aisha and Maria.
Yes.
Both Aisha and Maria went to the party, to the occasion. Both Aisha and Maria. Once you can use both, it must be followed in that sentence with and. For it to be correlative enough, you can't just use both, and you are not using two things or two persons together in that sentence. You have to just introduce and. They are twins. You have to follow one another. Either you take it, or leave it. Is it either you take it or leave it? We have correlative here because we make use of the first one, and the second one must also be in that sentence. So you can't just use one and ignore the other one. The two must come together in any statement that you want to make or any sentence you want to construct. The last aspect we are going to discuss this morning under conjunction, these are errors that you should avoid whenever you want to construct your sentence and you want to make use of conjunction with it. You just have to avoid these errors whenever you want to construct sentence and you want to make use of conjunction. We have two errors there that you must avoid. The first one is the use of double conjunction at a time. Error. That should be. Should be avoided. The first one is that whenever you want to make use of conjunction, you have to make sure that you don't use double conjunction at a time, only one conjunction. The use of double conjunction is not allowed. The use of double conjunctions is not allowed. You have to avoid that whenever you want to make use of conjunction. You don't use the two together. Example of such is that shouldn't use so therefore is an error. So therefore, but this is a conjunction and this is another conjunction. The two must not follow one another, or something like this. Although, but This is a conjunction. This is another conjunction. You shouldn't use, you have to avoid using the two together in statements you want to make. The common one is this, still yet. Still yet. This is a conjunction. This is another conjunction. The two must not come together in whenever you want to make use of conjunction. You don't just say, still yet. Still yet, I didn't go there. Still yet, she failed the exam. So don't say that. It's an error in which it's not allowed in English language. So another error that you must try, and you should try to avoid whenever you want to make use of conjunction, is using more so. Using more so for more over. More so for more over. What this is telling you is that you shouldn't use more so in the place of moreover. The reason is that more so in the first place does not even exist in English language. That is what this is telling you. Telling you that you should avoid to use more so. Don't even use it at all. Instead of using this, just make use of this, because you can find this in English language. But this cannot be found under English language. So you should try to avoid it whenever you want to make use of conjunction. You better use moreover instead of these imaginary. This is just imaginary words. Someone just follow it. It's not part of English language. But this is an authentic conjunction or authentic word that you can be found under English language. So you should try to avoid this one totally. But it's just an imaginary word. In the first place, it does not even exist in English language. So try to avoid it whenever you want to make use of more so and more over. So we've come to the end of today's class. But before we go, we are going to see there is going to be an assignment after this topic, which I'm going to post on the platform, inshallah, tomorrow. So you find your assignments